सब्सक्राइब कीजिए विजय कुमार माई न्यू क्लासरूम, प्रेस बेल बटन टू एंजॉय वीडियोस ऑन इंग्लिश लेसन्स एंड ग्रामर टॉपिक्स। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हे लुक एट मी, व्हाई आर यू लुकिंग एट दैट एड्रेस? दिस इज सिंपल, अ नेम प्लेट, डॉर्लिंग 46 मार्क ऑन स्ट्रीट। यू लुक एट मी चिल्ड्रन, आई एम इन द क्लास, व्हाई आर यू लुकिंग at this nameplate? 11th class, do you know this address? Have you heard of this address any time? Yes, you are right. This is very much related to you. It is not a simple address. It is the address. The address where Mrs. S left all her belongings before fleeing Holland to Mrs. Dorling's residence. Yes or no children? Here, protagonist, the author, aati hai after the war, after so many years, when her mother Mrs. S is no more there, she has died now. Here, protagonist has a quest of finding herself, than just finding some mere commodities. Kyunki aap jante hain, German invaded Holland during World War II, where 90% population was of Jews, and they had to flee because they wanted to avoid the concentration camps of Germans. Mass genocide jo wo kiya karte the. To yahan par dikhaya hai is lesson mein, main baat kar raha hu the address, chapter 2, 11th class, your book supplementary reader snapshot ka, The Address by Marga Minco. We are going to study today, and before going further, I would like to say, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it. So, effects of jo hai war on children kya rehta hai? Kyunki wo to usme choti si bachchi thi. The narrator wants to convey the experience of Holocaust. Kyunki jab war hota hai, not only the stories of gallant of soldiers, but pain and struggle of laymen also come out with war, such stories also. Human predicament during war time is in this lesson, and it is described so poignantly as if it is her personal loss. Yes, it is having an autobiographical note also, kyunki writer khud in sab se guzri hai, uski writing bhi dekhi. On this chapter, children, I have given you two videos already on title, writer, theme and characters, and video number 206 it is, and summary in Hindi is there. Agar aap ye summary Hindi mein dekhna chahte hain, to is link pe click kijiye, ye aapko lekar jayega is summary ko Hindi mein dekhne ke liye. And in this video, I am here with summary in English. Now, author Mrs. S's daughter, क्योंकि autobiographical note है, वो खुद जाती है. Author goes to Mrs. Dorling, this address, number 46 Mark on street. She does not know whether she has rung the right bell or not, because she does not recognize Mrs. Dorling, क्योंकि वो बहुत छोटी थी उस समय, है ना? She stares in silence because she saw years ago. And she was having a doubt this time whether she has rung the wrong bell or right bell. So a woman opens the door, who is wearing a green cardigan with wooden buttons, which buttons have gone pale now, pale of washing. And that woman also saw that narrator was looking at that cardigan. So that lady, Mrs. Dorling, she hid herself behind the doors so that she is not recognized that she is the same lady. Lekin wo writer also recognizes that, yes, I am at the right address. And narrator asks that lady, you knew my mother? And that lady also asks, have you come back? The author replies, no, no one has come back. It's only me. Sorry, I cannot do anything for you, but madam, I just want to talk to you at once. Please. And what she replies? no, 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 this is not convenient for me now. You come another time. And she closes the door as if she did not want to disturb anyone in house. So the narrator is on the step of that door now. But she sees that curtains are moving and someone is staring out of those curtains. And it is confirming her that she is at the right address. She once again looks at the nameplate. She decides to go back to station because that lady is not welcoming. She is hesitant. This is what writer Marga Minco wants to convey us. कि during war time कैसे जो है relations भी जो है छोड़ देते हैं, non-cooperative हो जाते हैं. So she once again looks at the nameplate. She goes back. She is going back now. She thinks of her who gives her that address. She remembers कि how years ago it had been in the first half of the war. वो याद करती है, it struck me something missing, various things. She came for some days to live with her mother from his hostel. It struck into his mind that something was missing from their house. Various things were missing. She was surprised, and her mother was also surprised that she noticed all these things missing. And she remembers while going to station ki how she asked her mother about Mrs. Dorling. And her mother told that she was an old acquaintance. Mother was saying she was an old acquaintance. She had not seen her for years. But she did not believe it, how she suddenly turned up, renewed their contact. And then how since then jo hai, she had come regularly to their home, taking this item, those items, all the times. Every time she came to them and she took something with her, be it their table silver, cutleries there, and their antiques plates hain, and vases jo hai wo sab jo hai ek ek karke that lady jo hai wo usko leke jaati hai. She remembers this time at present ki how she asked her mother ki had she agreed on to that lady Dorling should keep everything with her, and when they are back they will take and she will hand over it to them back. So how her mother jo hai replied to it, that it will be an insult to that lady who is helping us, rather she herself is in danger. Because when she goes out of door with a full suitcase or bag, she herself is in danger. Us par bhi koi shak kar sakta hai beta. We can't ask her like this. And she remembers how her mother also knew that the narrator was not convinced with her argument. So remembering all this, she arrives at the station and she is not paying much attention to things on the way, that street, houses, you know. So here is her first visit since war, after there is normalcy. So she did not want to go further, that was necessary. Jitna tha utna hi wo janna chahti thi, because those streets and houses jo usko yaad aa raha hai will up the sides of streets hain, houses hain, full of memory from previous time usko yaad dilati hain. So she sits in train, she is going back as Dorling is hesitant in getting her into her house. In train what happens, she could see Dorling's face. Usko yaad aata hai ki haan mujhe yaad aata hai. Once I saw my mother about to see someone out, she was talking and she introduced me with Mrs. Dorling. This is my daughter. At that time Mrs. Dorling picked up the suitcase and she went. She asks her mother that time where that woman is living. Is she living far away from here? So wo bolti hai ki my mother told me that address. It is number 46 Marconi Street where this lady is living. And though I remember this address, wo yaad karti hai, but it took me years to go there and look at the things that my mother handed over to Mrs. Dorling. Though she remembers ki I am not interested in that stored stuff, rather she was afraid of it, hai na? Because in confronting with things that had belonged to a connection, and that connection is no longer existed. That connection of mother daughter is no more, but connections with their belonging is there. Narrator sees that these things are hidden in cupboard boxes for years, because for Mrs. Dorling they were just things. And now, as gradually normalcy is there, war is no more, liberation is there, so she is curious to see all, to know about all those possessions at that address. That's why she decides to visit once again, because though her first attempt was unsuccessful, so she decided to try once more. So she goes there once again. This time it is not Mrs. Dorling there, it is her 15 years old daughter. A girl opens the door now, and she asks, narrator asks that girl if her mother was at home. To bolti hai, no, my mother is not at home, she is out, he is doing an errand. To bolti hai narrator ki, I will wait for her, let her come back. And during that time, during that wait period, she sees those old things, antique pieces. She sees there a candle holder hung there, and she remembers ki how they never used it, because it was quite cumbersome to use that for candle burning. So they used just candlesticks. Wanted, because she wanted to see the missing things, and she sees there lots of things, but the way was very tasteless. It was not like my mother used to keep those things at their proper place, proper system was there. But this time she could see so many things that belonged to her, but and they were kept in very tasteless manner. Furniture was ugly, a muggy smell was all around there. So she scarcely dared to look around. She just sat at chair, and she sees at the tablecloth, and she remember it must be burnt. So wo mark jo tha burnt ka, still it was not repaired. So that Dorling's mother prepares tea for him, and she sees that Dorling's daughter is also having the broad back like her mother. So she sees those spoons, cutlery, teapot, etc. And she also sees that this teapot is having a golden border, and she remembers that this one also belonged to her. And Dorling's daughter jo hai opens a box and takes some spoons out of that nice box, and wo bolti hai ki, do you know, we have so many things, these are very antique pieces, my mother says, and we have lot more if you want to see. She just points out around the room, but narrator knows that which things she is talking about. Wo janti hai ki ye sab hum use kiya karte the, aur wo batati hai ki jo cutlery ko dekhti hai. Once her mother tells him to polish these spoons, and in conversation she came to know that these forks, knives and spoons are of silver, and that she, that girl is having this time. It was silver, and she did not know at that time. It is known to her only when her mother told her once. She showed many things to the narrator, and she opens door to show more to the narrator, but narrator said that it's time she should go now. And when she starts going, spoon forks started jingling, as if they was saying her to take them with her. She comes out of that house, nameplate, she looks at which was showing number 46 mark on street. She sees that the address was correct, and now she has had a glance on everything. She could see and touch those things, but she did not want to remember those things anymore, because objects jo hain linked in your memory with the former times lose their value when you see them in strange surroundings. Jab tak wo aapke paas hain, ek attachment rehti hai, lekin jab wo kisi aur ke ho jate hain to wo attachment unme nahi rehti hai. Aur wo, she also remembers ki all these things cannot fit in her new house. Wo chota bhi hai aur ye samaan bahut zyada hai. So she resolves to forget the address, this address, Dorling number 46 Marcon Street, forget, because of all things she had to forget, that would be the easiest, this address would be the easiest. तो ये कह के लास्ट पैराग्राफ में भी वो रिजोल्व करती है कि आगे से वो इधर नहीं आएगी. सो चिल्ड्रन, दिस वॉज द समरी इन इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी बोथ, एंड वी आर कमिंग नेक्स्ट विद लाइन टू लाइन फुल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस लेसन. यू क्लिक दिस बटन, दिस विल टेक यू टू लाइन टू लाइन फुल एक्सप्लेनेशन के पार्ट वन में. ज्वाइन मी देयर ऑल्सो. बाय बाय.